Live. News 8's Good Morning Connecticut starts now.
Hi, everybody. It is 6 o'clock on this Monday morning. Yes, it's Columbus Day. A lot of folks have the day off, right?
Including some people who work here.
We're here for you. I'm Jocelyn Momento.
We don't.
The people who are usually sitting in these two spots on the couch. I'm Kent Pearson. We've got, of course, Chief Meteorologist Gil Simmons and Teresa Dufour to keep an eye on the roads
ways,
for us.
Which are real quiet.
It's a good Monday morning for everybody,
right? We're easing into it, yes.
A little sleepy, though, for a lot of people, I'm sure.
They were up late watching this heck of a debate. Mm-hmm. Started off on just the right note, huh? With them not even shaking hands when they walked out there.
Yes.
Yeah, it was. You could have predicted that. But it just got nastier from there. And we haven't seen anything like this. At no time in the modern political era have we had a presidential election anything like this, including the topics that we have to discuss, too.
Yeah, but you know what? There wasn't really anything new that they revealed last night. Just a lot of heated exchanges, and they got kind of rude.
Yeah, we got taxes and her emails, and he actually threatened to throw her in jail.
Exactly. He said he was going to get a special prosecutor to do that.
Yeah, we've never seen this before.
Well, at least you know what you're getting. He's telling you in advance what he's planning on doing.
True, very true.
Well, certainly a night of fireworks on the debate stage. Let's take a moment right now. Watch one of those heated exchanges over Clinton's email server scandal.
If I win, I am going to instruct my attorney general to get a special prosecutor to look into your situation, because there has never been so many lies, so much deception. There has never been anything like it. And we're going to have a special prosecutor.
It's just awfully good that someone with the temperament of Donald Trump is not in charge of the law in our country.
Because you'd be in jail.
And but see, in the spin room afterwards, people were saying that's exactly her point, that in this country, we don't threaten to jail our political opponents if we win an election. They called him a banana republic kind of dictator and how he sounded there.
But in this country, you can say whatever you want to say.
Well, that's true. That's true. Right? But we've never seen anybody say these things before in a presidential debate stage. So it's just amazing, and hope everybody out there got to watch some of that last
night. But
they
were nice at the very end. They shook hands.
Oh,
and
I missed that part.
They actually said something nice about each other at the back end. Somebody asked that question. You gave up?
I did. Time to go to sleep. Get up early. I'm paying for it today. The amount I watched. Hey, we have a chilly start out there this morning. It's going to be a little colder than what a lot of people have been used to. And we're going to keep that chill around through tonight. As a matter of fact, I want to share this with you. We have a frost advisory that has been issued for most of the state. And as we were talking a few minutes ago, if you were tuned in during the 5 o'clock hour, yes, this is coming right down very close to the immediate shoreline. Much of the state painted in blue here, and that is showing the areas that have the highest threat of frost. But even closer to the shoreline, if the wind dies down tonight, and this is up through tomorrow morning at 9 a.m., expect some frost. The only need 34 to 36 degrees to get frost out there. So if you have some expensive plants, you might want to cover those up. If the garden is still doing well, I would get out there and pick it clean today. 40s out there now, and it feels like 30s whenever that wind comes through. 47 in New Haven, all is dry, and it's going to be a bright, sunny day today, Teresa, but you're going to need the jacket.
I grabbed it this morning before I left. It was certainly necessary, along with the seat heat. Hello, good morning everyone. If you're leaving the house right now, here's what you're dealing with. I gotta tell you, it is a real simple ride to work. I think a lot of people are enjoying three-day weekends because of Columbus Day. These morning drive times, status quo, you're traveling between 66 and 65 miles per hour, and it is a breeze out there. I went through all 210 of our traffic cameras, and just not a lot of volume here at 604. You're looking at Waterbury. This is one of the spots there is going to be midday construction. Only those ongoing emergency projects are going to be out there today, so 84 eastbound and westbound, 23 to 25A. Good morning to you, New Haven. We are traveling as you approach the bridge, and also down 91 seems to be A-OK there. And trains and planes are running on a normal schedule. Metro North running on a Monday schedule, so no issues there. Check the cameras over on our app and at WTNH.com. Joss and Kent, back to you both.
Teresa, thank you very much. And now continuing our 26th vote 2016 coverage, both presidential candidates battling out in their second debate of this election cycle.
Tension straight out of the gate with no handshake between the two bitter rivals. Their fiery exchanges in a moment. But first, a new poll overnight declaring a winner. A CNN instant poll showing Hillary Clinton winning. Voters expressing support for the Democratic nominee, 57% to Donald Trump's 34%. The poll also tracking viewers' pre-debate preference. 58% of debate watchers say they supported Clinton even before the debate.
And the two White House hopefuls battling it out over Trump's taxes and, of course, Clinton's emails, topics we've repeatedly heard about throughout this campaign. Clinton once again apologizing for her decision to use a private email server while she was Secretary of State, calling it a mistake, but insisting no one breached national security.
After a year-long investigation, there is no evidence that anyone hacked the server I was using, and there is no evidence that anyone can point to at all, anyone who says otherwise has no basis, that any classified material ended up in the wrong hands.
And Donald Trump defending himself against reports that he may have avoided federal taxes for nearly 18 years.
Did you use that $916 million loss to avoid paying personal federal income taxes?
Of course I do. Of course I do. She complains that Donald Trump took advantage of the tax cut. Well, why didn't she change it? Why didn't you change it when you were a senator? 68%.
Trump also saying he would cut taxes for the middle class, and Clinton wanting to impose a special tax on the wealthy.
Immigration into the United States continues to be a hot topic in the 2016 presidential race. Donald Trump saying at the debate, the U.S. is allowing refugees from Syria and the Middle East to pour into America without knowing a lot about them. The Republican nominee once again talking about extreme vetting, and Hillary Clinton saying there will be some kind of vetting process and that it will be as tough as it needs to be.
People are coming into our country like we have no idea who they are, where they're from, what their feelings about our country is, and she wants 550% more. This is going to be the great Trojan horse of all time.
It is important for us as a policy, you know, not to say, as Donald has said, we're going to ban people based on a religion. How do you do that? We are a country founded on religious freedom and liberty. These are very important
values to me. Trump not answering a question about how to stop Islamophobia in America, and Clinton saying that all Muslims should feel welcome and included in society.
Well, young voters certainly watching last night as well, and the University of New Haven holds a special debate night watch party ahead. Why one student says he supported Donald Trump until now.
Plus, Brady is back. A lot of fans happy to hear that. New England Patriots star quarterback Tom Brady returning to the gridiron for the first time this season, putting an end to the Deflategate saga. But first, here's Gil.
He got it done, didn't he? Wow. Hey, we have a quiet commute out there as far as any rain because it is drying out, but there is some wind and some chilly temperatures. Coming home, it's not going to be all that much warmer. Only in the upper 50s to near 60 today. Teresa, we'll talk about some 70-degree readings, though, in the 8-day coming up.
Ooh, that's not so bad. I'll enjoy that. And good morning, everyone. If you are leaving the house right now, don't expect a lot of volume on the roadways because of the holiday, but we are watching an accident. I'll let you know where this is, and we'll talk about the delay it's causing when Good Morning Connecticut continues right after this.
Six ten, and we continue our Vote 2016 coverage. Many voters are hoping that these debates like the one we had last night are going to help them decide who to vote for on November 8th.
Time is quickly running out with the election just 4 weeks away. This will be the first presidential election for a number of voters, including students at the University of New Haven. More than 100 of those students watched Sunday night's debate together on campus, and one of them says he supported Donald Trump until now.
He went in there with a lot of rhetoric that didn't really help anything else in this country in a positive light.
This is my first election for president, and we had to pick between, like, literally the lesser of two evils at this point.
Several students took part in a focus group before the start of the debate. Organizers hope to have another watch party for the students during the third and final debate next week.
And speaking of that, the presidential candidates have just one more time on the debate stage before the general election. Their third and final debate set for October 19th, that is Wednesday of next week. It'll be held at the University of Nevada in Las Vegas, and you can watch the showdown right here on News 8 beginning at 9 o'clock that night.
And a new era for New England star quarterback Kent.
The four-time Super Bowl champion is just minutes away from starting his 17th NFL season.
Yeah, Tom Brady there hitting the field with his game fully inflated this time after serving a four-game suspension. I bet they did over the Deflategate scandal. We'll talk about that next. Stick around.
And onto the field comes number 12.
Yes, he is back. New England Patriots star quarterback Tom Brady getting quite a loud welcome. The Patriots putting him on the field once again, bringing an end to the 21-month-long Deflategate saga. Brady suspended for four games over what the league called an illegal scheme to use improperly inflated footballs in the January 2015 AFC Championship game. Brady fighting the NFL commissioner's ruling for more than a year before accepting his punishment.
The 39-year-old seeming to enjoy every second of his season debut.
I was just pretty, trying to focus on what I, what my job is and what I have to do. And, it felt very much like a normal week for me, once I got into it. So, it was fun to come out and play and, fun to win. I think that's the most important thing.
He looked pretty rust-free after taking time off. Brady passing for 406 yards and three touchdowns in his much-hyped return. The New England Patriots thumping the Cleveland Browns 33-13.
You know he wasn't about to lose that game. There's no way.
He
must have been practicing a lot.
Right.
Well, they've been winning without him. So, yeah. Of course, with him back, they were going to win. And it was the Browns.
Thumping.
Oh.
That was the term.
I like the Browns.
You like the thumping?
I do.
Yes.
Thumping. We use that with snow, but I didn't want to bring that up when you get heavy snow. But
we get thumped?
Yes, exactly.
Okay. I've been thumped a few times by snow, I think, yeah.
Yeah? Oh, yeah. It's coming. Well, not anytime soon, though. Here's the deal. I'm just going to move it along right here. We have some patchy clouds out there in western Connecticut now. All is quiet, although it may feel pretty cold to you outside this morning. It's really all about that wind that's making it feel cold. Tomorrow morning, we're going to have colder temperatures without the wind. It'll be in the 30s for many, many spots. Upper right-hand corner. That is what is left of a combination of the front that moved through our area and what is left of Matthew in eastern Canada. We did get some beneficial rain, though, from the immediate shoreline, eastern, let's say, third of the state, an inch or more in many spots. The further northwest, you had much less, like Linda's area and Warren up through Torrington, hardly anything at all. But any we did get was much, much welcomed here because of this drought that's been ongoing. We're going back to the drought pattern. Pretty quiet in New Haven now. A little bit of wind out there. Temperature 47 and it's feeling like 39. New London breezy 48. You'll need a jacket there. Northerly winds 13. Sunglasses and a jacket will take care of it for you today. 11 o'clock only in the 50s and then we're optimistic for 60 degrees at the shoreline at 3 o'clock, 58 inland, and a fall feel right through 5 o'clock evening commute time frame. If you are going to work, still going to be cool with temperatures in the 50s. So frost is an issue tonight. There is a frost advisory for about 90% of the state until 9 o'clock tomorrow morning. Coldest time of the day tomorrow will be right around daybreak. But if you're still trying to keep that garden going, cover those plants up. Otherwise, I would pick it clean today. We do have a shower threat on Thursday, but it's like one or two, very minor. Most of the time, most of the state will end up dry as the pattern is going back to that drought pattern. Big area of high pressure, not much going on. Highs today, 61 Milford, Norwalk 60, Newtown 58, New Haven 60. Eastbound we go 62 Mystic, 59 Salem, Killingworth 59, 61 Middletown, Norwich 60 in the northern tier of the state, upper 50s to around 60. The exception, Northwest Hills, 56 Torrington, 54 Woodbury, Killingly 60 and Willimantic 60. But with wind, it is going to feel cooler. Great day though. Maybe take a few photos out there with some of the leaves and, make sure you're wearing a heavier jacket. 58 to 60, winds gusting to 30 at times midday. The wind will die off though after 2 o'clock today. Mainly dry, couple of sprinkles or brief showers on Thursday. And that's about it for any outdoor activities. You're gonna be okay for much of the week, except for that morning chill.
Yeah, it's getting to be fall, huh, Gil?
Seat heat alert.
It is true. Good morning, everyone. We're dealing with really light volume on our highways and byways this morning. The one alert I have for you is right there. This is right at the bottom of Route 8, Route 25. It's on the ramp to 95 North. You can see some flashing lights there. One car spin out. It's not causing too much of a delay, but it's really the only thing I have to show you because I don't think a lot of people are heading to work this morning. The map is really quiet, maybe some stop and go starting a little bit on the Merritt Parkway, Bridgeport into Fairfield, certainly no surprise there. But southeastern Connecticut looks terrific. New London, Hartford, Waterbury, and we'll make that ride over the bridge if you are heading into the downtown area. Guilford to New Haven will take 12 minutes, and that's pretty good. Morning drive times, you can see for yourself, we're traveling between 63 and 69 miles per hour, so no obstacles in your way there, and no brake lights here in Waterbury, so go ahead and start your week. Kent, on over to you.
Teresa, thank you. A developing story this morning shouldn't affect our commute here, but over on Long Island, they're still trying to clear the tracks for the morning commute after a work train and a commuter train sideswiped, causing a derailment in New York that injured dozens of people. Governor Andrew Cuomo says it appears a train doing maintenance work somehow violated the clearance space of a Long Island Railroad train. Both trains collided just after 9 o'clock Saturday night. The National Transportation Safety Board will determine the exact cause.
U.S. Senator Charles Schumer of New York wants inward-facing cameras on all New York City area trains to avoid accidents like the recent crash in Hoboken, New Jersey. The senator says the cameras would help several ways.
Inward-facing cameras would do two things. One, God forbid after a crash, they'd show you what went on in the cab. We don't know what went on in the cab yet. But second, they might prevent things.
Schumer says Amtrak has put cameras in all of its Northeast Corridor locomotives. 2 years ago, the Metropolitan Transportation Authority announced plans to install video cameras and audio recorders on most Metro North Railroad and Long Island Railroad trains.
Well, now to the Note 7 nightmare, a developing story this morning. Samsung suspends production of its Galaxy smartphone over renewed concerns that those devices can catch fire.
Plus, the power of Mother Nature. Hurricane Matthew uncovering something likely unseen in 150 years. The bombshell discovery next.
Almost literally a bombshell, yeah. Good morning to everyone in West Haven, in Clinton, and in Groton. And right now, a live look at Old Glory flying in New London. Wherever you're waking up, good morning, Connecticut. ...624 on your Monday morning, a developing story now. It seems Samsung's Galaxy Note 7 nightmare keeps getting worse. Its electronics team temporarily suspending production now. Two major carriers, AT&T and T-Mobile, on Sunday decided to stop offering replacement Note 7s. Soon after the Galaxy Note 7 hit stores in August, some users reported that their phones were catching fire. Samsung officially recalled the phones last month, blaming faulty batteries. Replacement phones were supposed to solve the problem, but customers reported the same dangerous problems.
Explosive disposal teams are on the scene in Folly Beach, South Carolina, after Hurricane Matthew washed up a 150-year-old surprise, some military artillery. That storm blowing through this part of Charleston with such force, its winds unearthing nearly a dozen cannonballs from the Civil War. A portion of the cannonballs detonated on the beach, and the rest blown up elsewhere. The first shots of the Civil War fired at nearby Fort Sumter in 1861. Left over from there.
We always hear about beach erosion with these storms. Mm-hmm. We don't think about the beach is going to erode and uncover something cannonballs from 150 years ago.
Incredible. And a lot of those towns and cities all along from Savannah up had record tide levels with 30-foot waves. So you can imagine that a lot of stuff was stirred up. And, you know, those waves just chipped away with a lot of erosion there. So very tough down there, anywhere from Virginia down to the south, not to mention at inland areas. I'm looking at some of the rain totals here. Looks like Wayne County in North Carolina, 15.24 inches of rain. The storm now moving away from the U.S. Good news. It is heading up into eastern Canada. It actually dropped 2 to 3 inches even up in Maine before it continued to move away with that cold front that came. came through. We are in high tide now. It's coming in through about 6:45. So about the next 15 minutes or so, and it's going to be pretty rough to get a boat out on the Sound today because of those northerly winds that are going to be continuing through the day. But it will be bright, and you may be picking up some branches in your yard. Did you notice some of those driving in, Teresa? I had a bunch of branches on my street.
I noticed a lot of leaves everywhere. Yeah. They've already fallen off the trees, yep. And that could be difficult to drive through, so be aware of that. But the ride to work this morning, I think it's going to be an easy one. So far, so good with the Columbus Day holiday. A lot of people are not out there, and we're just not seeing the volume we typically do here at 626. We are watching an accident. You can see some flashing lights right underneath the banner here. This is Route 8, Route 25, going to 95 northbound. Looks like it's in its final stages of clearing. It's just a one-car spin out on the shoulder. And again, not much of a delay associated with that one. We'll send things back to you both.
Teresa, thank you. A backdrop of controversy, Donald Trump's sexually aggressive comments about women in a recording from 2005, taking center stage early in the second presidential debate. The Republican presidential nominee playing both defense and offense.
Ahead, the attacks he launched against Hillary Clinton's husband, former President Bill Clinton. Stay with us. Another half hour of Good Morning Connecticut starts in just 2.5 minutes.
Live, News 8's Good Morning Connecticut starts now.
Thing to avoid talking about your campaign and the way it's exploding and the way Republicans are leaving you. But let's at least focus on some of the issues that people care about.
I'd like to know, Anderson, why aren't you bringing up the emails? I'd like to know. Why aren't you
getting up the
bottom? No, it hasn't. It hasn't. And it hasn't been finished at all.
Ken Karpowitz has a question.
It's nice to one on three.
The question from
a barrage of attacks, Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton unleashing jab after jab at the second presidential debate.
And disaster relief, a developing story this morning. Volunteers from Connecticut helping out in Florida, Georgia, and the Carolinas following Hurricane Matthew. Ahead, the challenges they face when responding to a disaster.
Over the hurdle, another developing story this morning, this one involving the future of thousands of jobs right here in Connecticut.
The time now, 6:30 on this Monday morning. Welcome to Columbus Day. I'm Kent Pierce.
And I'm Jocelyn Moment. It's great to have you with us. Let's get you started with a look at our weather. Storm Team 8 Chief Meteorologist Gil Simmons. All right, Gil, tell them all what they need to do this morning.
Well, I'm not sure if you want to look at these numbers. I'll start that way because it is that chilly out there. Good morning. If you haven't been outside, we have chilly temperatures and a wind to go along. So it does feel like, yep, fall is here. You can't fight it anymore. Basically 40 to about 47 degrees around the state now. If you think this is chilly, tomorrow morning we actually have a frost advisory that's up. It is going to get cold right down to the shoreline. So about 90% of the state will have the risk of temperatures in the 30s. If the wind dies down, we could have a widespread frost first thing tomorrow morning. So if you're still trying to keep that garden going, you might be out of luck by tonight and tomorrow morning. The sky is stunning, though. It's beautiful out there in New Haven. 47 feeling like about 39 to 40. Sunny skies, it's not going to warm up a lot, but through 9 o'clock, we'll be stuck in the 40s. After that, Teresa, some 50s. We'll talk about 70, though, later in the 8-day coming up.
All right. I like the sound of that, Gil. Thank you. And I think you're going to enjoy the ride to work this morning if you are heading out the door to work. I don't know how many of you are because there's not a lot of volume. In fact, it's a real easy ride. So if you are coming into New Haven, lucky you, the bridge is clear, Long Wharf is clear, 91, 34, 63. Any way you come in here, there's no obstacles. I'm going to take you over to Bridgeport. We had an accident on the Route 825 ramp to 95 northbound. It was on this side of the highway, but also on the opposite side. So this is the northbound side. You can see some sort of activity. So not much of a delay out there, not a lot to talk about, just some flashing lights, maybe a minor accident or police activity. Meanwhile, the map looks good. If you're moving into Hartford, no issues in the capital city. Waterbury, we are going to have some midday construction with the highway widening project, but all in all, we are cruising. And again, you saw it on the live cameras, pretty easy over the bridge right now. Guilford to New Haven will take 11 minutes. Check the cameras for yourself on our app and at WTNH.com. Joss and Ken, back to you both.
Teresa, thank you. Back now to our vote 2016 coverage. With his political life on the line, Donald Trump facing off for a second presidential debate with Hillary Clinton.
And Trump's campaign in a nosedive after comments recorded years ago were made public. Trump under fire for that recording, which revealed his crude comments about sexual advances with women. And the issue coming up in the opening minutes of the debate, the Republican nominee insisting he did not approach women without their consent.
Well, I don't think you understood what was said. This was locker room talk. I'm not proud of it. I apologize to my family. I apologize to the American people. Certainly, I'm not proud of it.
We've seen him rate women on their appearance, ranking them from 1 to 10. We've seen him embarrass women on TV and on Twitter. So this is who Donald Trump is.
And then 15 minutes in, Trump accuses former President Bill Clinton of sexual misconduct. Hillary Clinton not willing to engage.
If you look at Bill Clinton, far worse, mine are words and his was action.
When I hear something like that, I am reminded of what my friend Michelle Obama advised us all. When they go low, you go high.
And before the debate, Trump unexpectedly appearing on Facebook Live with women who have accused former President Bill Clinton of rape and unwanted advances.
Covering New Haven County, a new team of prosecutors in New Haven focusing on sexual assaults in an effort to present stronger cases and make the criminal justice process easier for victims. The prosecutor and the special crimes unit developing protocol for themselves and police. Now, those guidelines for sexual assault cases, beginning with the time a complaint is made to how they are handled in court. Now, that team, the first unit of its kind in the state. FBI data shows nearly 900 reported rapes in Connecticut last year, but only 33 of those cases solved.
Now to a developing story this morning. Helicopters ferrying food and medicine to parts of Haiti devastated by Hurricane Matthew. Still no electricity there, and water and food are scarce. Along the East Coast, the devastation from Matthew is still lingering. In North Carolina, flooded cities trying to dry out, and those downstream keeping a close eye on rising rivers.
The weather map shows that Hurricane Matthews is well off the shore into the ocean, but in our minds, the impact of Hurricane Matthews is still here and extremely dangerous.
The flooding disaster expected to slowly unfold over the next several days as all that rain flows into rivers and then downstream toward many of the same places devastated by Hurricane Floyd in 1999.
Volunteers from Connecticut are down south this morning helping with the relief efforts from Hurricane Matthew.
And News 8's Noelle Gardner is live at the American Red Cross in Hamden to tell us what they're doing. Noelle, good morning.
Good morning, Ken and Jocelyn. Well, volunteers tell me today they have a game plan. Some of them from Connecticut in South Carolina, they tell me first this morning they will assess the damage and then they will, if you will, carve a path through those hardest hit areas to try to help people in need. On Friday, we introduced you to Joe Apicelli. He left Connecticut for Columbia, South Carolina at the Red Cross headquarters for the disaster operations. Now, teams of volunteers had their trucks inspected yesterday for safety so they can get to where they need to be today safely. Now, volunteers say they have many challenges ahead of them when responding to a disaster. And this morning, Joe says he's in Columbia and Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. He will be attempting to get to the hardest hit places to help folks.
The water is still 4, 5, 7 feet deep in some places. So as soon as we can get through that area, clear the brush away, clear all the debris away, we'll be able to get in there and start serving people.
And crews first have to clear the passage so the American Red Cross teams of volunteers can get to those affected areas. Right now, they tell me the water is about 5 to 7 feet deep in some areas. And volunteers tell me that there are thousands of people still in shelters. There are about 17 shelters just in the South Carolina area where those volunteers are. They tell me they want to get people out of the shelters and back into their homes safely. I'm reporting live in New Haven. I'll send it back to you guys in the studio.
Well, Noelle, 17 shelters and all those volunteers. What exactly are the volunteers handing out to the people in those shelters?
Ken, right now they're handing out ready-to-eat meals, and soon they hope they will hand out hot meals when they can get everything going. And they say they're also handing out toiletries and diapers for babies. And they also say they do need donations if you can give them. I'm reporting live in New Haven. Now back to you.
All right, Noelle, thank you very much. A developing story now involving thousands of jobs here in Connecticut. A final hurdle cleared to keep Sikorsky Aircraft in Stratford for at least the next 16 years. Union workers voted Sunday to approve the deal with the state. The General Assembly approved the deal last month, which includes making 200 King Stallion helicopters right here in Connecticut.
All right, I love this, and you and I are both foodies. Free apps for foodies. Looking to save both time and money? Well, there's an app for that, and we're helping you stretch your dollar with some free downloads, including the Tinder for food.
That sounds interesting. Not quite sure what to make of that. Plus, we got Cruisin' Connecticut. News 8's Ryan Christopher introducing us to the group sculpting natural works of art one notch at a time. But first, here's Gil.
Wait, I thought he made that one. All right, well, I guess we'll find out what the real deal is coming up. Hey, we have a great day in front of us, but it's going to feel chilly. We'll run down how strong the winds get. And a day that we will touch 70, all of that coming up. Didn't you think he made that, Teresa?
I think he pulled a fast one on you and you fell for it, Mr. Simmons. Pretty light volume out there on the roadways. We are watching a vehicle that is taking out a lane right at the bottom of Route 8. I'll show you some live pictures and let you know what's happening all over Connecticut when Good Morning Connecticut continues right after this.
.642 on your Monday morning, and in this morning's Cruisin' Connecticut, the Connecticut Woodcarvers Association sculpting natural works of art one notch at a time.
Carving enthusiasts passing down the lost art to scout troops and new artists. News 8's Ryan Christopher visited the Connecticut Forest and Park Association in Middlefield for an inside look. Good morning, Ryan.
Good morning. I guess I would fall under those new artists, I'm assuming.
Very new.
Yes.
Did you learn anything?
Well, you'll find out here coming up, but this isn't the wood shop you remember from high school. These carvers, man, they're really full of passion.
So, Leo, how long have you been wood carving?
Approximately 70 years.
So did you start before you were born or what?
I started during World War II. Well, I prefer either an available type of wood, which around here is white pine.
Now, this type of woodworking goes back centuries. Most farmhouses had shave horses. We used them for skinning our sticks.
Yeah.
The walking stick program that we've developed with the Connecticut Forest and Park Association. And we've done walking sticks for their 5K walk and run. This stick in my hand is the stick that kicked off the whole program. When my daughter was diagnosed with MS, I completed it, and shaft is twisted because of the full disease of the MS.
Hey, what do you call this creation here?
I just call it my monster in the basement.
Now, do you keep it in your basement?
I work on them in the basement.
So how long does it take you to make something like this?
Hundreds of hours.
When I started looking at the piece in here, it started to look a little bit more like a house, so I may try to put some house-type features in here.
Oh, this is a piece I've been working on. I like to call it Family Reunion. Look, you have Keith Koontz and Gil Simmons and Laura Hutchinson and, oh look, even Teresa. Now, are the mutton chops a requirement to be part of the association?
Definitely.
So I have some work to do.
You're going to have to work on that.
Give me a few more years.
So there it is, Connecticut Woodcarvers Association, very talented crew, and we were able to make a couple creations for you guys, if you take a peek right here.
This
is
well,
that's Gil. I said on Friday I would make a Gil, so I made a Gil and put a little acorn hat on top of
his
head.
So this is what he was talking about earlier, that you made something?
Yeah, well, that I did make, and then we wrapped up this little stick. That's for you,
wow.
Ken. Yeah, I don't know if it's big enough for you. Try it out.
Well, now I can speak softly, because carrying a big stick.
Can you use that?
Exactly.
Sure, absolutely.
Great.
Yeah,
great.
Whenever Gil gets
here
out of line.
My gosh. So, hey.
How long did that take you?
That took me about 20 seconds, I would say.
Okay.
A little bit longer. So,
uh-huh.
Yeah.
Right.
All right.
That's that.
Ryan, thank you very much.
You're welcome. You're welcome.
And we are taking Cruise in Connecticut to schools around the state. Send us a video through Report It or using the hashtag CruisinCT on Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. Tell us what makes your school so fun and unique and why we should visit it.
Didn't know he was so talented, did you?
Well, of course. I just didn't know about that talent. Food can dominate Facebook, Instagram, even Pinterest. If looking at those pictures or recipes makes you hungry, listen up.
News8's Laura Hutchinson is helping you stretch your dollar with some free apps that foodies will love, saving you both time and money.
If you're used to swiping left or right for dates on Tinder, consider downloading Tender. It's considered the Tinder for food, with photos and recipes from people all over the world. Just swipe right to save a recipe or left to skip over it. Want to head out to eat but hate to wait for a table? Download No Wait. The app essentially waits in line for you. Once your table is ready, you'll get a text. Already, No Wait is being used in more than 4,000 restaurants across the country. Once you have your food in front of you, take that perfect picture with Foodie. The app has 26 filters customized for food pics. Then share away to Facebook, Instagram, or any other social media site. The best part about these apps, they're free. Helping you stretch your dollar, I'm Laura Hutchinson, News 8.
Okay, Teresa and I are a little jealous. We didn't get one.
He did a great, well, you know what? He might be working on one now. Uh-oh. And that stick is gone,
right? You might get
right?
one for, on CT style, maybe.
Oh, I could only hope.
Good for you, yeah. You're keeping that very close to your heart there.
I am, the mini me, right there. There you go, right there. Hey, we have a great day coming up today. It is going to be a little chilled. You probably already noticed that out there this morning.
Yes.
Windy, too.
Windy, and we're going to be stuck with this with a frost advisory, actually, tomorrow morning. So it is going to get a little colder. This is on the backside of that storm, and I want to give a shout-out to this photo here. I want to share this. We had a group of truckers leave Connecticut, and they brought a bunch of generators down south. So I just want to share this picture with you. John Donadio, one of those truckers with some others here, and I just want to show you that Connecticut people are helping out way down south. And as that storm continues to move away, the water will recede down across the mid-Atlantic. And again, no more threats in the short term, although we are not done with hurricane season. And there is some hints at something, let's say around the 20th through 25th of October down around the Caribbean. We have a lot of time to watch that. This is the last of it right here, moving up through eastern Canada. Winds coming through on the backside of that cold front that did squeeze Matthew up to eastern Canada and caused it to not do that loop that so many Floridians were worried about. Now we have the wind and the chill that's coming in across Connecticut. So we're brightening up out there. 47 degrees with a northwest wind at 10 miles per hour in New Haven. New London, 48. Feeling colder with the wind. Same kind of deal all the way up through Hartford. And our temperatures will be slow to move, even though we are expecting sunny skies, a few patchy clouds early on, but a good look to the day in the afternoon. It's a good day for some photos. If you have any of the trees that are really turning in your neighborhood or what's left of them after the wind yesterday, you'll have a nice blue sky backdrop. It will be great. Make sure you have a jacket. 60 at the shore, 58 inland for a chilly day. Tonight, temps drop, and I mean right down to the shoreline. We'll have temps in the 30s, so frost is a possibility, especially if that wind dies off. We'll look at scattered frost right down to the 95 corridor. And then the frost advisory will be done around 9 o'clock tomorrow morning. Brief shower on Thursday, but not much rain. We're sliding back into a mainly drought-type pattern with a big area of high pressure. It's just a weak front coming through on Thursday that'll drop the temperatures a little bit by Friday. So today, not all that warm. 58 to 60, mostly sunny, but some of the wind gusts to 30 miles per hour. So it is going to feel a bit chilled out there. A couple of drops Thursday. The flip side, though, a warm-up, 69 to about 70 degrees Thursday. Then it cools down next weekend. At this point, fingers crossed, is looking a lot better than last weekend with all that rain that we got, but we do need a lot more. That's just the tease on Thursday with a few drops, but 71, Teresa.
All right, sounds good, Gil. Thank you. And I think you're going to enjoy the ride to work this morning. We're really not dealing with a whole lot of volume. You'll see this traffic map is showing us a lot of green speed data. I checked with state police. We're not watching any accidents. So if you have to go to work this Monday, the roadways are certainly agreeing with you. The only thing we're seeing is a little bit of stop and go in Fairfield County, and obviously no one's surprised about that. But the good news this morning, there's no red speed data, so you're certainly not at a a standstill. This, I would say, folks, is the heaviest. It's traveling through Fairfield as you approach the rest area. But once you move a little further south, get into Westport, you are just fine. No delays there. Meanwhile, New Haven, it is a breeze. The bridge is at the speed limit. Long Wharf looks good if you take 91 southbound coming from Wallingford, North Haven, right into the Elm City. You could set the cruise control and take off there. And here's our green speed data showing us the ride over the bridge from Guilford to New Haven will only take you 12 minutes. Kent and Jocelyn, back to you both.
Teresa, thank you. Debate stage showdown. Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton delivering jab after jab during a town hall style presidential debate. An audience member giving them possibly the toughest question of the night.
Would either of you name one positive thing that you respect in one another?
Can the two candidates respond with a little R-E-S-P-E-C-T?
Just a little bit.
Just a little bit.
Just a little. Sorry.
We'll have that in just a moment. And a little more from him.
No. Welcome back. We want to continue our Vote 2016 coverage. Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton facing off in their second debate Sunday night.
For more than 90 minutes, the nominees attacking each other on policy and on each other's personal controversies. Then, at the end of the town hall-style debate, one last question, giving them a chance to end on a friendly note.
I respect his children. His children are incredibly able and devoted. And I think that says a lot about Donald. I don't agree with nearly anything else he says or does, but I do respect that.
I will say this about Hillary. She doesn't quit. She doesn't give up. I respect that. I tell it like it is. She's a fighter. I disagree with much of what she's fighting for. I do disagree with her judgment in many cases. But she does fight hard, and she doesn't quit, and she doesn't give up. And I consider that to be a very good trait.
You think there's a chance they could be friends after this?
Well, they were friends before it.
That's true.
She was at her wedding.
They just shook there, huh?
Yep. Half fighting tooth and nail, these presidential debates have ended with a brief handshake after notably not doing so at the beginning of the debate. So didn't shake hands at the beginning, did so at the end. That was about as warm and fuzzy as it got there.
Yeah.
Was the I disagree with everything, but your kids are nice. You fight hard.
Yeah, last what 15 seconds?
Yes, exactly.
Good Morning Connecticut. Good Morning America continues coverage of the presidential debate number 2 with analysis and live team coverage at the top of the hour, 7 o'clock, right here on News 8.
You know, there's another debate, one last debate. So we'll get one last look at both of these. And be sure to stay with News 8 for continuing coverage of Vote 2016 all the way through the general election in November, just 4 weeks from tomorrow.
All right, and what have we got on tap today for weather?
It's going to be on a chilly side. Fall is definitely here. You're going to feel it as soon as you get out there. The wind is going to be gusty. So chilly today, 58 to 60 at best for the afternoon. Some of the winds up to 30 miles per hour. It is going to warm up this week up to about 70 on Thursday. A quick shower possible, but no soaking rain like we had yesterday. So that is about it.
With those crosswinds, you kind of got to hold on with both hands.
Yeah.
Today.
Well, if you're heading out on the roadways, I don't think too many people are with the holiday.
Pretty empty.
Pretty empty, not a lot of volume. You'll see our traffic map is not indicating any obstacles, so pretty good time to leave the house. Here are our busy cameras. The only one that's really indicating some stop and go is maybe Fairfield as you approach the rest area, but around the state, we're looking good. Trains and planes are also on time, and getting over the bridge right now into New Haven is looking good at right around 12 minutes.
Hey, Ryan, and you showed up some new talent to us. We had no idea you could do that.
I don't know if that's talent. Yeah, well, today was walking sticks. Tomorrow, hockey sticks. We're going to the Bridgeport Sound Tigers, so that should be an interesting ordeal.
Can you skate?
I haven't skated in like 10 years, so fingers crossed.
Okay. We'll see.
That wraps it up for us this morning.
He's going to come in with a black eye and missing teeth tomorrow. Good Morning America up next right here on News 8 and ABC.
Enjoy the rest of your day.
Have a good one.